Okay, this is Investing, Risk, Return, and Liquidity by Joey Helm and Joel Fisher. The first step in investing is to create a put and take account. This is usually going to be the first savings that you build up when you are coming into college right out of high school, around late teens. It'll be basically the money that you're going to use for your bills and emergencies. And to fully complete this step before you proceed, you should probably shoot for 3 to 6 months of pay or 3 to 6 months of bills taken care of in this account before moving up. Usually this account will deal with very low risk but virtually no return. Once that's created, you can start beginning actual investing, and this involves investing in other low to moderate risk investments such as bonds and mutual funds. And for these, time is money, because for most of the investments you're going to be making, it's very low return, but over the course of many decades, you can create a very nice return off of it. Once you pass that, you can start systematic investing, which is creating your budget and it having your money put for stocks placed in that budget. And for these, a lot of these are also long-range goals where you place money into a stock or mutual fund and also annuities and have them collect interest over upwards of 20 years. The risk is slightly higher than your beginning investments, but they depend on which medium you decide to choose. Now on to strategic investing. This is where you start managing your portfolio and adding different types of investments, whether it be stocks, bonds, or annuities, to diversify your portfolio to reduce possible losses while maximizing your gains. These are usually less time restricted, as you can be accessing these gains within 5 to 10 years, depending on the medium. And again, moderate risk to moderate reward. Once you've achieved a very good knowledge of investing, you can move on to possibly speculative investing. Now, this is a step that some people never reach, but depending on how safe you feel with investing your money, you could start on this. This is more involving the very volatile stocks, including your penny stocks, and also dealing with things as collectibles, precious metals, especially gold. Now, these are going to be stuff that could change hundreds of dollars over the course of very small amount of time. So these are ones that you really have to watch out for if you decide to venture into. Okay, your low-risk investments are usually the ones you're going to be accessing through a bank, such as your checkings or savings accounts, and also CDs, which are certificates of deposit. These will usually have very low interest rates, or with the CD and also bonds, you have to have very long times for the interest to actually build up to something fairly useful. Moving on to medium risk investments, we have your stocks, mutual funds, and also real estate. These have a much higher interest rate and less time to actually require to have a good buildup of earnings made compared to the low risk, but they are much more volatile and there's much larger chances of actually losing your money with these. And they're also not nearly as liquid as your checkings and savings accounts within the bank. The high-risk ones are the ones we spoke of earlier, with the penny stocks, your collectibles, and also specifically gold. And these are the highest reward possible, which can be climbing upwards of thousands of dollars over relatively short periods of time. But they're also extremely low liquidity and, again, extremely volatile in the sense that they could climb just as fast as they could drop. So these are ones that aren't necessarily for the average person.